Good morning, students. I hope you are doing well. As we were doing determiners, so in continuation with that, we are doing its third part. That is, we have done articles, we have done demonstratives, we have done possessives. Now, the fourth one that we are going to do, that is quantifiers. What are quantifiers? They are what? They are adjectives or phrases that serve to answer two possible questions, that is how many and how much. Quantifiers answers basically these two questions, how many and how much. You already know what are adjectives. An adjective is a word that modifies a noun to make it more specific. That is what adjective. So quantifiers, it basically answers two possible questions, that is how many and how much. Like some, much, a little, a few, many, etc. Now, we are doing now types of quantifiers. How many types of quantifiers can be? The first one is quantifiers that describe quantity. Now, first we will doing the quantifiers that describe about the quantity. Then, first is countable nouns. You know what are countable nouns? The nouns which we can count, like eggs, garden, girls, boys, these are what? Countable nouns. This answers the questions how many, for example, a few, a number of, several, etc. These are what? These are quantifiers. How many? And it answers the questions of how many, a few. For example, if you have got a sentence and you have to use quantifier in it, and these quantifiers will tell you the answer of how many. There, if the sentence is like that, how many eggs you want? A few. Here, it answers the question of how many. That is why it is quantifier that describes quantity. We use this with countable nouns. That is, it answers the question of how many. For example, a few, a number of, several, etc. Then, next is uncountable noun. Nouns which we cannot count. These answer the question where we use these type of quantifiers, a little, a bit of, etc. And it answers the question of how much. Like, if we use example of a little, or little, or few, these are what? These are uncountable nouns. Like, there was little hope for the patient. Hope is what? We cannot count hope. So hope is uncountable noun. That's why we have used little with that. A little also, it also conveys that a small amount is there. Few conveys the idea of small number. So we cannot count these things. And it is answering the number. It is answering that how much. How much is there. Like a little, example of a little is, a little knowledge is a dangerous thing. We cannot count knowledge. So knowledge is uncountable noun. While some of them are used with both, we can use them with both countable and uncountable nouns. There are some those quantifiers also. These are the ones that answer both questions. And these answers both question how many and how much. How many and how much. These answers both the questions, like such as, no, none, some, a lot of, etc. These are what kind of quantifiers? These are answering both the answers, how many and how much. These were quantifiers of describing quantity. That were describing the quantity. Now next is quantifiers that express attitude. That shows the attitude of a thing or a person or a speaker. The words few, little, a few and a little serve to describe the speaker's attitude to the quantity being described. Okay, what kind of quantity is described there? These words describe those feelings of the speaker. These quantifiers. These are what? We are talking about the quantifiers. The first two carry negative suggestions, like few and little. Few and little. Means it's kind of negativity. So negative in the sense like they are very less. That's why it is called negative. The and whereas the last two carry positive suggestions. Last two means a few and a little. These carry a positive suggestion. Then come comparative quantifiers. These are much, many, more and most. Describe in ascending order. You know ascending order? Ascending order is that when the thing or number, they are ordered in such a manner from smallest to the largest. So these are what? This is the smallest and this is the largest. These are in ascending order. What they are describing? Increase. They are these quantifiers. These are describing the increase. Much is used only with uncountable nouns. You know what is uncountable nouns, which we cannot count. Many only with plural countable nouns. And more and most with both. Both means we use with countable nouns also and uncountable nouns also. These all things you have to memorize. The more you will use, the more you will use in your sentences, you will be able to learn that how we will have to use this where in which sentence. Then few, fewer, fewest, little, less and least. Here the chart decrease. The first three in descending order are used only with countable plural nouns. First three here. Few, fewer, fewest. Descending order is what? From largest to smallest. Largest here is few, fewer, fewest, little, less and least. This is the smallest. This is in descending order. Here the charts decrease. The first three in descending order are used along with countable plural nouns. First three we use with countable plural nouns. The last three, that is little, less and least, again in descending order we use with uncountable nouns. These things you have to memorize. I have shared one chart also in PDF with you. Learn that chart. It will be very useful for you. Here are few examples of quantifiers. First one is, there are some books on the desk. Some with countable noun. I saw few people in the class. People, we can see that few is used in the negative sense, that there were only few people in the class. Not many, only few. Then next, she has much knowledge about the topic. Much is used with knowledge, that is uncountable noun. A little knowledge is a dangerous thing. Now, a little is telling the answer of how much that we did there in the first quantifiers that describe quantity. Knowledge is uncountable noun and it is answering the question how much. How much knowledge is a dangerous thing? A little knowledge is a dangerous thing. There was little hope for the patient. Now, little hope for the patient. It is also telling us in a negative manner that I have told you, quantifiers that express attitude. This little is telling that there was very less hope for the patient that he could survive. Hope is uncountable now. So these were all quantifiers. Go through the video, go through the PDF, and if you find it any difficulty anywhere, you can text me, you can call me. Thank you.